I think, honestly, this government roundtable is one of the most unique events I go to every year, because it brings together not just local businesses, but also politicians from across the spectrum, and even, you know, outside experts and occasionally even people like me who are just here to learn. So I don't think I go to any other event where there's such a melting pot of different people and the opportunity to listen and learn and collaborate and discuss the challenges that Greece is going through, but also the very real opportunities.
You talked about the score of the Greek economy. What is our score?
So at the moment, our Greek rating for the Greek sovereign is a BA1 rating with a stable outlook. But within that, you know, there are different things that go into making up that kind of rating. And one of those is our assessment of economic strength, or if you like, the closest thing to a score on the economy. And at the moment, that is BAA1, so it's a bit higher.
Mm-hmm. What are your predictions for European Union, especially for Greece, for the next 5-10 years?
Wow, I mean, that's a big question. It's obviously a challenging time for Europe because there's an awful lot going on in the rest of the world, and a lot of those developments are going to be beyond Europe's control. So there's a challenge in terms of how Europe responds to events such as the Israel-Hamas conflict, which is ongoing, but also, frankly, you know, the more fractious relationship between the US and China, which of course dominates global trade, and the spillover effects from that are going to be enormous. I think one of the challenges for Europe is it has to remain outward looking in response to all of those developments. I do worry a little that if Europe focuses too much on itself and is too internal looking, it could become a bit of a walled garden. But I am very encouraged that policymakers in Europe seem to be very aware of that, and that's why we have new discussions about expansion into some of the Balkans again. The support for Ukraine, of course, has been enormous from European Union member states and other countries as well. So I think Europe is aware of this risk, but the challenge is always, can Europe speak with one voice on a whole range of different issues?